The title of this course, Chemistry in the Earth System, really gets at the way that we're trying to highlight the synergy between the different sciences here. We want the earth science phenomenon to motivate students and give the chemistry content more real-world relevance. And at the same time, understanding the chemistry is going to give students a deeper insight into the processes that are shaping the earth, and it's going to equip them to overcome some of the environmental problems facing our planet. The conceptual flow you see here from the framework is one way to accomplish these goals. Now remember that the framework is just an example. Districts, science departments, and teachers can choose any course sequence they want, adopting this conceptual flow exactly or starting completely from scratch. Let me show you what we were thinking when we designed this course sequence. We chose combustion as a unifying theme because it illustrates so many chemical principles and has really profound implications for the Earth system. We start off with a brief instructional segment that focuses on observing combustion at the macro scale. Students practice observing and describing the bulk properties of matter and changes to it. They also might notice those gases given off, including the CO2 that's going to be one of the threads that ties together many of the topics throughout the course. In order for students to explain all the different things that are going on during this phenomenon of combustion, they really need to be developing their model of the nature of matter. And that model should start off pretty simply, thinking just about interacting particles. And that lays the foundation for thermodynamics, for reaction kinetics, and the ideal gas law. It'll allow them to really understand the nature of properties like density, and processes like heat transport. These heat transport processes really come alive when you're looking at the Earth system, as they control everything from global climate to plate tectonics. As students explore the evidence for the motion of massive blocks of the Earth's crust, they begin to ask questions about what's causing that motion, ultimately realizing that it's all driven by heat transfer from Earth's hot interior to the cooler surface. In high school, students are now extending their model of matter so that it goes beyond simple particles. They're ready to look at the internal structure of the atom and explore the patterns in the periodic table that result from that structure. These patterns allow students to predict how atoms will interact and bond together in chemical reactions. In the instructional segment on chemical reactions, students focus on explaining macroscopic behaviors using models at the atomic scale. They use their model of the internal structure of the atom to explain how chemical bonds and intermolecular attractions are all driven by electrical attraction. This model allows students to explain chemical potential energy measured at the macroscopic scale in terms of changes of electrostatic potentials as atoms change bonding partners. Students can revisit the combustion reaction in particular so that they can explain how fossil fuels are an energy resource for society, and also noting that CO2 is a product. This sets up an in-depth exploration of the chemistry of climate change. Here, students treat the Earth as a thermodynamic system, and they develop a model of Earth's energy balance. They explain the role that CO2 plays as a greenhouse gas that absorbs energy in infrared due to the specifics of its chemical bonds. But the discussion goes beyond chemistry, noting the impact of climate change on Earth's systems, including the interactions with human society. Then students return to the topic of chemical reactions from the perspective of chemical engineers. They're looking at how to manipulate chemical systems to adjust the rates and products of chemical reactions. One way to introduce these topics is through a chemical system involving carbon dioxide in Earth's atmosphere and its ocean. The ocean has become 40% more acidic since humans began burning fossil fuels as our primary energy source. This has massive implications for marine life. It's not just the tropical coral reefs that are affected either. Many of the creatures at the base of the food chain here in coastal California are already being stressed. Students investigate the chemistry of carbonic acid and how it affects marine life. They tie these changes to human activity and design solutions that are going to help minimize these human impacts. So as we step back and look at the course as a whole, you can see that common thread of combustion that really ties together the chemistry and the earth science, and how the earth science phenomena really have the potential to engage students and relate the chemistry to important issues that are going on in the world around us.